Okay, I guess this will be like part two on the
Benchmark Hatchet.
I did a video, I just checked, it was like 8 months ago, I guess, so anyway, it took a while, but this is their little camper racks, they call it. It's 1¼-pound head. It's got the, it's like a nylon handle that's, it's hollow. There's something inside of it, like around here somewhere. I don't know if it's solid there or something, or there's fiberglass in it or something, but anyway,
I did sharpen it a little bit.
So I don't think it's perfect yet, but it's a lot better than it was. It was like basically flat on the end before. But the head is fairly symmetrical. It does have a bit of a, like one side is, I don't know, sort of cupped in or something. Yeah, I think this side's a bit flatter than this side, but anyway. But the profile isn't terrible. But it probably could be thinned a little more, but it does chop a little bit. It's not, like, it's not as good as like this. This Collins axe. So you can see how thin the edge on that is. But this actually was fairly thin from the factory, so it was a lot less work. Like this one was, watch part one, it's almost basically flat on the end. Like it was terrible. So it was quite a lot of work involved, but it's got a Chinese, well, I think the whole thing's made in China. But the steel seems to be actually quite decent when you file on it and cut on it. And it had a, you can't see it now, but I think it had a decent amount of temper. It was like up to here somewhere. So it's got lots of life in it, but it's pretty wedgy shape, so it'd be good for splitting kindling and stuff. And you can do some small cutting. Like this one's a lot better, but even this tube handle one, it seems to chop better. I was just doing a little bit of messing around here with some maple branches and stuff like that, sort of seeing which one cuts better. But it's got a pretty robust edge on it, so it'd be a good sort of camp beater axe or root cutter or something. You probably won't damage it that easily. But if you really want to cut stuff, you probably get this one. But for splitting and cutting, this is probably better. And it's got a longer handle too, so it's a little bit. So it's, I don't know. But they're all sort of in this. Well, this, the Collins one and that one are sort of similar price on sale. This was like $12, I think. This was like $14 or $15. There's a new one at Home Hardware. It's like Task brand, it's called. And I believe they're made in Mexico by Trooper as well. But so I got one of them on order. So, and if it ever shows up, we'll give that a look, see if it's the same or not. But this one, grinding on it a bit more today. This is certified, but it's really got a weird thing going on here. Like, let's see if you can put the file on it. See how this big dip here? It's high on either side, and then it kind of dips in. Where you put it this way, see, it kind of teeter totters. So it's kind of annoying because the edge is almost like cupped this way, and then it sort of like goes this way as well. Like, so you gotta kind of grind, kind of goes in and it comes up again, so you gotta kind of grind that off. But then you kind of want to flatten this to straighten the edge, because when it's got like this weird curve, it's like you cut from a certain direction, it won't bite into anything. It basically glances. This one's a bit more symmetrical and straight. This one was pretty decent. from the factory, but so I guess, you know, between China and Mexico, I guess, but not all these are like that. But all these certified ones were like that. Like all the, like I've got three of them. They all have this weird indentation thing going on. So you gotta kind of not really grind on this side very much, but grind on that side a lot. So, anyway, it's the joys of cheap ass hatchets, I guess. So it, like, and these ones were blunt on the end, sort of basically like that one. But so. Anyway, they're all works in progress, but I think I got this one so it's usable. But it does have a nice, at least, you know, feels good. Most of the weight is in the head. This one doesn't feel terrible, but they always, I don't know. These ones, I don't think the grip is put on straight, so that kind of makes it kind of weird, but I don't know. I'm not sure who certified this thing, but I never used an axe before. But anyway, so I think the Collins is probably the best of the lot for the price. But these ones are a lot probably more robust and have wooden handles and stuff. So, anyways, that's sort of just part two of this. I might try to thin it some more, but it's at least now I got it to a point where I actually can use it for something. So, take it up to the camp and hack down some stuff, and cut up some kindling, and so forth. But these here were like $9, so they're the cheapest. But they do take a lot of work too. But they do. This one does cut fairly well. It's just everything is wonky about it. But whatever. It's got decent steel, and it's got lots of temper into it. I don't think you can see the hardness line anymore, but it was, I think it had similar to that or a bit more. So anyway, thanks for watching. That was sort of a long rambly video, but whatever. Just wanted to show that I actually did do something with this. I actually did use it. That's kind of a rarity on YouTube. Like, look at my unused axe, and I'll cut one piece of wood and oh look, it's good. Anyway, talk to you later.